Joining us now on the phone is Brendan O'Neill. He's a photographer. He was actually on the main stage of this concert festival while Jason Aldean was performing. Brendan, can you hear us?
I can hear you.
Thank you so much for being with us. This is Poppy. I'm here with John Berman. You and I spoke on the phone a little earlier this morning, and you sent us some video that is just surreal. We'll play it for our viewers as we speak to you. Talk to us about what this was like, because when the shooting broke out, what were your initial thoughts?
So we were backstage, stage right, and I first remember hearing like pop, 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 pop. And it sounded like it almost came from like the speaker system. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh man, that doesn't sound really good. And then it happened again, and I look and I saw the tech guys, and they're scrambling around like trying to figure out what's going on. And then it happened again, and it was pop, 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 pop. So loud, like super loud. And then the next thing you know, the sound is completely off for the musicians, and all you hear is like this heavy machine gun just going off, and you just hear people just screaming. And so we're just like so confused, because we thought this was like some technical difficulty. Now it's like something more. There's someone yelled a gun and people are screaming. And so we're exiting off stage and we're going around the stage towards the right, and people are just like climbing all over the fences trying to get out, and people are just screaming again. And then you just hear pop, 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 pop. It was like, I mean, it sounded like 50 plus rounds were just going off, and people to like the left and the right of us are like down on the pavement. Like we made it so like we went towards like the parking lot. And we were able to like hide behind this cop car. And I remember just getting around this cop car and just hearing bullets just whizzing and just like bouncing like on the ground nearby. And these girls were like just screaming and crying, and they were just like covered in blood, and just, oh man, super heavy. And then, again, we hear these rounds go off. It felt like minutes that these heavy machine guns were just, like, going on and just wouldn't stop. We then ran from the cop car, and the girl was laying down on the ground. Her friend was hysterical, crying. She got shot. Turns out she got shot in the head. And then I remember my buddy like trying to help her and got her to the police car and got her inside. I don't know. She wasn't moving. She was completely unconscious. And then from that point on, again, we just heard more and more and more just machine gun, and we just bolted towards the parking lot. And then we saw security people too, like running like away, like the police like had no idea like where it was coming from or what. Like they were just like, you gotta run to safety, you gotta get to safety. And so we just like bolted to the parking lot, and oh, thank God this guy came in and asked if we needed a ride, and it was just like just were able to just jump in that car and leave. And man, I'm like in complete shock right now. What just happened?
It is completely
trying to explain to you the best I can.
Brendan, you've done an amazing job explaining to us what you saw. What you went through is something that no one should ever have to go through. It's extremely traumatic, and it takes incredible strength not just to get through it, but to be able to talk about it like you are this morning and look back at this event. Just again, you're okay. Is everyone that you were there with okay this morning?
Yes, my buddy's good. Our other friends that we were, we got broken up because we all just, like, were just bolting and just, yeah. My close friends are good at the moment, so I'm just really thankful. I'm blessed to be here and able to talk to you guys.
We are as well, Brendan. I understand that you helped a girl who was shot in the head. Is that right?
Yeah, so we were running, and this girl's down on her knees next to her friend, and she's like, help me, help me, help me. She's shot. And we stopped, and we checked it out, and it was like, she wasn't responding. She wasn't moving. So a couple people around helped pick her up. My buddy helped get her into this police car that was just like a bunker for people, just hiding behind it. Yeah.
Brendan O'Neill, again, a photographer who was on stage, lived through this ordeal. Brendan, again, thank you so much for being with us. Thank you for what you did or tried to do to all those in need as you were getting yourself to safety during this event, the deadliest mass shooting in U.S. history. More than 50 people killed, 400 at least injured. We're getting new details, new developments. We're waiting to hear from the president. Stay with us.